Learning is continuing, but I think before the next speaker comes, because when he speaks, it's like we all get mesmerized, and it is like, no, we just feel like we continue to listen to him, and he continue to talk for the whole day, and that is the magnetic field of this particular person. So at this point of time, I really will take 1 minute so that we really, really become very, very receptive. And you all know, in order to welcome a speaker and become more and more receptive, what we all need to do? No, we'll all have to stand. Before he comes, let's all stand. Everyone, including the speakers, okay? And ek mic hai. Okay, not required.
Okay, we will do it for everyone.
Okay. Spine straight. Really, really, we really need to learn. So, spine straight. Inhale. Chin up. MFR, take a tempo. MFR ticker tempo. MFR ticker tempo. Nilesh ji ka tempo. Okay, we need to really do that so that when he is there, he will just speak his heart and we all will get a lot of benefit out of it. Sir, this is for you, and I think we really want to be more and more receptive when you are there. So, speak there or? Thank you, sir.
Hi, good morning to all of you. And market ke upar Prashant ne Srini ne baat ki, to main market ki baat nahi karta hoon. Main badalte samay ki baat karta hoon. Many a times it so happens that when things are happening in front of us, we are not able to visualize it. So let's see how things are changing. There was a time when our men's lost World Cup semi-final against Australia. And now our girls go and beat Australians in World Cup semi-final. There was a time when our males used to go and get Olympic medals. And girls used to go and get Miss World, Miss Universe title. Now our girls go and get Olympic medals and hum mard log jaake Mr. World ka title leke aate hain. So hamari aankhon ke samne samay badal raha hai. And badalte samay mein, it's important to capture what's changing so that all of you get the conviction to stay invested. So let me ask you first question. How many of you believe in ghost, bhoot, preet, pisaach, chudel, dakan, dain? Okay, only one person. By end of this statement, everyone in this room will be convinced that there are ghosts. And isko ek interesting karte hai. So other than that gentleman, everyone has said there are no ghosts. And if I make you convinced that there are ghosts in India, then all of you have to start an SIP in Kotak Mutual Fund. Fair deal? Sir, koi bhi scheme, liquid fund mein bhi kariye, mujhe chalega. Though aapke liye it will be detrimental. Done. So in India today, we are capturing world's largest ever ghost busting program, which is called Aadhaar. Out of 16.5 crore LPG connection, because now Aadhaar is mandatory, they have captured 3.5 crore ghost. Out of 11.5 crore ration card for which Aadhaar has become mandatory, 1.6 crore ration cards were of Bhutia account. In fertilizer, now they are making Aadhaar mandatory. They haven't yet made Aadhaar mandatory. And already 300 fertilizer dealers have given up their license to distribute fertilizers because ghalmel abhi nahi ho sakte. So now, I have proven to you that 5 crore ghosts have already been captured. And in fertilizer, there will be many more captured. So, except you, Manish bhai, baki sabke paas se SIP ka check collect kar lena jaane se pehle. The second thing, I'm sure all of you remember there were newspaper items that so-and-so politician was overstaying in a bungalow. In 2014, there were 342 bungalows which were being overstayed by Bahubalis. People who had political power, they were overstaying in their bungalows. Can you guess how many people are overstaying in bungalow today? 2014, 342. Today, 3 people, just 3 people. Now, have we ever seen a cleaner India than this? Where a Bahubali is being thrown out of a bungalow which he is or she is illegitimately occupying. This is changing India. Now, how many of you have visited Taj Mahal? Most of us. And if you haven't visited, sir, I'll recommend you. That's far more better than me. Now, I don't know how many of you, when you visit Taj Mahal, have focused on one plank which is on the left-hand side of the entrance, which talks about how many gold coins were used by Shahjahan to build that magnificent monument. If we convert that gold coin's value today, the approximate cost of Taj Mahal is roughly 6,000 crore. Now, did it include land value? Did it include minimum labor wages to laborer? I don't know. But assume that 6,000 crore was the cost of constructing Taj Mahal. Now, in India, we were running a scheme which should have constructed 5 Taj Mahal every year. And in 8 years, it should have constructed 40 Taj Mahal. But all of us know there is only 1 Taj Mahal. What is that scheme? That scheme was known as Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme. We were spending 35,000 crore, 40,000 crore, 45,000 crore every year. What were we spending that money on? It was essentially digging hole and filling holes. Khadde khodte the, khadde bhar dete the. To Taj Mahal bana hi nahi. Now, since last 3 years, the government has made a statement that using MNREGA scheme, they have developed 1 million water bodies. Kahin pe kua khoda, kahin pe nadi ko desilt kiya, kahin pe ek check dam banaya. Essentially, 1 million water bodies have been created. Now, in such kind of audience, I always ask this question, how many of you have seen in last 3 years, 1 new water body? Kisi ne ek bhi nahi water body, naya lake, naya kuwa, nahi wow, naya check dam banta hua dekha hai? Most of the time, people say no. So we were also worried, is the government making right statement? Or are they not telling the truth? So we went to an agriculture economist who is not necessarily from BJP. And we checked with him, is this 1 million water bodies claim true? And he said it is possible. Then our question was, why are we not seeing it? Hum dekh kyun nahi paate? And his statement was that most parts of India has such parched earth that whenever rain comes, it gets sucked into the ground in less than 15 days. Unless until we see 5 good monsoon, we won't see development of these new water bodies. Now, if government is constructing 1 million water bodies over 3 years by spending 40,000 crore, how will it benefit us? I'll give you an example of my native place, Gujarat. 15, 20 years ago, if you had come to Gujarat, and I'm sure there will be some people here from Gujarat, the tea which I would have offered you would have tasted you salty. Not that I would have put salt into tea, But our water was that mineral laced that it was tasting salty. Then the people of Gujarat and the government of Gujarat came together to build water, to build check dams, to conserve water, to recharge groundwater. Over the last 15 to 20 years, they built 150,000 check dams. It ensured that the groundwater was recharged. And today, if you come to my native place, I can offer you a cup of tea which will taste sugary rather than salty. That is the reason why Gujarat agriculture has grown at 10% per annum. In all our media, we hear how China has a miracle economy. The farmers of Gujarat are growing at a faster rate than China for last 15 years. Hamare liye ghar ki murgi hamesha dal barabar hoti hai. So we need to, we can change entire Indian's agriculture system if this 1 million water bodies is a real thing. And many of you will have roots in rural India. Please go and check how tough situation is there in terms of availability of water. Even place like Cherrapunji, which receives world's highest rain, after monsoon actually ends up suffering with shortage of water. And that's why it's important to recharge this groundwater. Benefit of this will be reflected in double-digit agriculture growth over years to come. The third thing, all of you are harassed by GST right now. We are also party to it. Now let me ask you one question. India is in which continent? How many are saying Asia? I mean, wapas wo karna padega. All of you are wrong. And if I prove that India is not in Asia, you'll have to do another SIP. Fair deal? So when I was studying like you in my school days, college days, I also learned in the geography book that India is in Asia. Ab wahi knowledge leke main market mein aa gaya. And then I realized that India is in Africa. India is in Africa because our tax to compliance, tax to GDP ratio, our tax compliance ratio is lower than Ethiopia, Zimbabwe, Uganda, Rwanda. Yes. So hum kis muh se kehte hain ki hum Pakistan ke neighbor hai, Bangladesh ke neighbor hai. Hamari comparison to Uganda aur Ethiopia se hai. Now I am a Gujju bhai. In my entire family, I am the only person who does a job. I am the black sheep of my family, jo apni family tradition chhod ke naukri karta hai. Mere sare cousin brothers businessmen hain. And Ashish, tere bhi waise hi honge. Now, all my cousin brothers put together, in their entire lifetime, jitna tax bharte hai, I pay it in 1 year. Ashish, same. So, between me and Ashish, our sare cousin brothers represents India. Wo log ne puri zindagi mein jitna tax bhara hai, usse zyada hum ek saal mein bharte hain. And trust me, all my cousin brothers live in a better house than me, drive a bigger car than me, and they wear better clothes than me. Now, for the first time, I'm seeing that my cousin brothers are taking GST registration. This is beginning of a journey where we are moving from Africa to Asia. Teesri cheez, matlab hamesha, you know, jab humne career ki shuruaat ki, to gore ko dekh ke khade ho jate the. I started my career in a gora company, phone aata tha, main khade hoke leta tha. गोरे की गुलामी हमारी जहन में आ गई थी. इट वॉज पार्ट ऑफ आर डीएनए. नाउ कैन यू इमेजिन इंडिया वेयर गोरे की गुलामी हैज बीन थ्रोन आउट लाइक सौरव गांगुली डिड दैट. एब्सोल्युटली. We are now exporting Baleno cars to Japan. Our company Suzuki, Maruti Suzuki, is bigger in market cap than Suzuki. It makes 2 times more number of cars than Suzuki worldwide. There is something which government of India has done which is now being exported to United Kingdom. And what is it? It is nothing but a simple thing. I'm sure if these bulbs are on, it will be LED bulbs. Before 2014, India had few million LED bulbs because they were available at 500 rupee per piece and no one wanted to buy that. When this government came, they ordered 5 crore LED bulbs. Apna matlab total stock 50-60 saalon mein becha tha, wo kuch 10 lakh, 15 lakh tha. Aur ye log ne 5 crore ka order diya. Obviously, that shook up entire manufacturing world. Every manufacturer rushed to India to sell LED bulbs. And the government said that we want it at a very, very cheap prices. 500 ka LED bulbs became 150, 150 became 85, 85 became 50. There is 90% reduction in LED bulbs between August 2014 and July 2017. Today, you can download an app called Ujala and measure how many LED bulbs are sold every year. Till today, and I must confess, I saw this app last in April 2017, so my number are 3 months outdated. They have sold 22 crore LED bulbs, helping save you and me 12,000 crore rupees every year. The target is to send 77 crore LED bulbs by 2019. This will help save country 40,000 crore every year. Every year. Now you decide. We had one country, one governance, where 40,000 crore was spent on digging holes and filling holes. You have another governance system where 40,000 crore will be saved for all of us, provided we just take the trouble of replacing a normal bulb with LED bulbs. Now, in which part of economy, which part of governance system markets will do well? All of you are smart enough to realize. Now, let me come to final 2 points. In our Hindu mythology, how do you get nirvana? How do you get moksha? There are various ways of getting nirvana or moksha, but one of them is called Triveni Sangam, mein snan karo. In Allahabad, where we do Kumbh Mela, if you go and take a bath in Triveni Sangam, where Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati Mata meets, you are supposed to cleanse off all your sins and you can go to nirvana. Ab wo prove karna mushkil hai, whether Saraswati is there or not, who knows. But I know in stock market, nirvana is possible. Moksha milega if there is Triveni Sangam of liquidity, sentiment and fundamentals. Liquidity, all of you are giving to us. In my whole life, I wanted an admiration where sell side broker will respect Indian fund managers rather than foreign fund managers. When I was part of Templeton, I had a fairly smaller corpus, and yet we were never recognized. Today, I can take with pride that to sell an IPO, all you need to come is to Bandra Kurla complex. You don't have to go to London, Singapore, Hong Kong. Khali BKC mein bech ke aapka IPO bik jata hai. And it's all possible because of you. So liquidity is coming to our market. And if I understand across my travel, there are many people waiting for corrections to come so that they can invest into the market. So there is more liquidity waiting to be invested. My message to all of them is that in the whole history of world, people have lost more money waiting for correction than in the correction. The second thing is sentiment. I mean, if you see Zee television, you'll realize that sentiment of Indians is very, very positive. If you see NDTV, you will realize that sentiment is very, very bad. The truth is somewhere between N and Z. But we believe overall sentiments are turning positive. People are appreciating work done by the government. Globally, investors are appreciating work done by the government. Yesterday in Jaipur, we had a CFO colloquium for corporate treasurer, and we invited a pension fund manager from US. He manages $100 billion. His exposure to India is 1%. And he said, I wouldn't mind increasing exposure to India to about 10% over a period of time, not tomorrow, not day after tomorrow, but 10% over a period of time. That's $10 billion. Year before last, we got $10 billion in entire year from all the FII put together. And day before, and yesterday itself, I had a person who was saying that I can cut the check of $10 billion, just one fund house. So sentiments are turning positive, and I really don't have to worry about sentiments now. The kind of work we have done on GST, demonetization, things are changing. Now the next question then comes, ki saab liquidity aage, sentiment aage, but what about fundamentals? Now there are four pockets of fundamentals. There is one pocket of fundamentals where you could see traces of Harshad Mehta and Ketan Parekh. There are stocks whose business is like this, market value is like this. There are stocks for which you have started receiving SMSs every day, ye kharid lijiye, kal double ho jayega. Please don't get into that trap. Humne enough 1991 mein loss kiya hai, 2000 mein kiya hai, ab usko repeat karne ki koi jarurat nahi hai. So ignore that pocket where there is overvaluation. Then there is one more pocket where, because of low floating stock, prices have reached to level which are unsustainable. Now I am on camera, so I cannot tell you the names of the company, but if I am there in the tea break, I'll be happy to share the names of these companies. But these are the companies where floating stock is so low that any price can be justified today. But the day floating stock will increase, those prices will come down. And I just want to give experience of my own bank. Kotak Mahindra Finance Limited came out with an IPO in 94-95. It was priced at a low price. It listed at some 20 times higher price than IPO price. So people who invested in IPO got tons of money. But people who bought post-IPO listing, they had to wait for 10 more years to make money on that. From 94-95 till 2004, Kotak Mahindra Finance share didn't cross its listed price, its listing day price. So there will be many more Kotak Mahindra Finance kind of experience if you get into a very, very high valuation, low floating stock. So please avoid that also, unless until you are willing to take a 5-year, 10-year, 15-year call. There is third pocket, which is PSU bank, IT, telecom, pharma. Here, valuations are cheap compared to their historical average. Valuations are cheap compared to market. But they are cheap for a reason. In telecom, two elephants are fighting, or three elephants are fighting. Why should you get into it? Let them settle and then you can enter. In pharma, US FDA is telling your factories are not good enough. So try to enter on a very, very slow and steady basis rather than lump sum basis. In IT, I mean, Infosys, TCS, Wipro, they all have to reinvent themselves. It will take time. You will get opportunity to enter. In PSU bank, NPAs have to be cleared. Today, most of the NPAs are disclosed, but a lot of NPAs are not yet disclosed. So you need to settle them and then you can enter. So there is this pocket of value, pocket of contra. You can enter there, provided there are some triggers. Then there is rest of the market where mutual fund investors, mutual fund managers, FIIs, everyone else is focused upon. And there you can build a portfolio. If all the things which I mentioned will change the country, will change the platform, we will see benefit coming through. Now, one final point. How many of you know of a gentleman called Bhagwat Chandra Shekhar? Good. At least there are a few people who remember India's legendary leg spinner. he had a defect in hand, and which is why he could never hold bat properly. He has the distinction or world record of scoring maximum number of zero in test cricket. He has had 23 ducks. No other test cricketer has ever achieved that number. All of you know Sachin Tendulkar, right? He is the god of cricket. No one has scored more centuries, no one has scored more runs than him. And hopefully no one will ever. You have Tendulkar, you have Bhagwat Chandrasekhar. And now a question is being put to you. If you have to take a call in one over, who will score maximum run? Tendulkar or Chandrasekhar? I mean, everyone will say Tendulkar. Nilesh bhai, kya bewakoofi jaisa question pooch rahe ho? Now, if I prove that Bhagwat Chandrasekhar will score more run than Tendulkar, then you have to start third SIP in Kotak Mutual Fund. Fair deal? So Bhagwat Chandrasekhar is someone like Prashant Jain, someone like S. Naren, someone like Sunil Singhania, someone like Nilesh Shah. We are the Bhagwat Chandrasekhar of India. The Tendulkar is Warren Buffett. The Tendulkar is Peter Lynch. And it's a matter of pride that since we launched our GILT fund, Government Securities Fund, in US dollar terms, that fund has delivered more return than Berkshire Hathaway, which is Warren Buffett's company. And this is true for almost all GILT funds. And Warren Buffett leverage karta hai, derivative use karta hai, long shot karta hai. Hum to sirf polio wale haath se betting karte hai. And with no disrespect to Warren Buffett, I can say, इस जन्म में तो वॉरेन बफे मुझे आउट परफॉर्म करे ऐसा कोई चांस नहीं है बिकॉज ही इज 84 इयर्स ऑफ एज. अगेन आई एम सेइंग दैट टाइम्स आर चेंजिंग. यू हैव लेजेंड्स ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. द काइंड ऑफ वेल्थ दे हैव क्रिएटेड इज अमेजिंग. द काइंड ऑफ रिटर्न्स दे हैव प्रोवाइडेड टू इन्वेस्टर्स इज अमेजिंग. Many of you would have done SIP in equity funds over the last 10, 15, 20 years. Just look at the kind of return we have generated. And all this we have generated in a period where when we started career, most of us started career in 90s, India was $250 billion GDP. Today it is $2.2 trillion GDP. So roughly $2 trillion got added. In that $2 trillion GDP, we created Infosys, we created ICICI Bank, Kotak Bank, Sun Pharma, Hero Honda, and so on and so forth. Most of us believe that in next 10 years, we will double India's GDP, we'll recreate entire India again. So what we earned over 25 years from 1991 to 2017, same opportunity will come over next 10 years. And if in last 25 years we could generate performance which could put Warren Buffett and Peter Lynch together to shame, I don't see a reason why in next 10 years we won't replicate it. In last 25 years, we haven't received money as much as we deserved. It is up to all of us to ensure that in next 10 years we compensate for that. One final point, and I'm taking a little more time, but hopefully you'll give me one extra minute. All of us respect our grandfather's generation because they fought for India's independence. In our opinion, we are also fighting for India's independence. Today, 25% of India's market cap is owned by foreigners. And about 10-odd% is owned by foreign promoters like Unilever owning Hindustan Lever, Suzuki owning Maruti. So 35% of India is already with foreigners. Only 15% of India is with domestic investors through mutual fund, through insurance company, and through retail ownership. If the current trend continues, in next 10, 15 years, we will see foreigners taking over 51% of ownership in Indian equity, and we'll be left with nothing. Do you want India's economic independence move into the hands of foreigners? Definitely no. We have to push people who are sitting in 7% return journey in fixed deposit, 9% return journey in gold, or 0% return journey in currency in tijori, into equity, which has delivered 15, 16, 17% return. And ye aap aur main hi kar payenge. We will be able to tell our children that we fought the war of India's economic independence, and last 3 years' trend is suggesting that maybe we'll become successful. Thank you.
May I request Apurva Bhai from Ahmedabad to please come and give a memento? I think everyone has got engrossed so much. Apurva Bhai is there. Arun Agarwal ji from Raipur. Achha, Apurva Bhai is there. Yeah. Session 2 room, we will have a 25-minute session with him on practice management. So, all those 5:30 today. Yeah?